That is the spark plug area. There we have one of the valves. That is the petrol mix intake valve. And that looks pretty clean on the underside there. Okay, that's not good enough, is it? There's the exhaust area. So, see if I can improve that a bit somehow. We'll try the brush again. Okay, this engine has been playing up very recently. It's time to take the head apart because I think the head is totally gunked up and needs to be cleaned. I'm going to wash it in solvent, probably just petrol. That's it, head is off. So let's have a look at the inside of this head. Curious to see. That's for goodness sakes, look, you can barely see. There's a valve. There's a valve and somewhere in there, I think under there is where the spark plug goes. So that, no wonder it's not working. I mean, for goodness sakes, that is just wow. So that, jeez, that needs a thorough cleanup, doesn't it? We're going to have a look at the top of the engine there. Okay, we might as well take that out and clean it as well, I think. Yeah. It's pretty nice, isn't it? You know, it's oh goodness me, the top of the piston just as disgusting. Can you see that? That is just epically bad. So, oh dear, oh dear. So I've got to give that a wash as well. Smell is quite, oily, sooty. Better be careful of this washer here. I don't think that needs to go up any particular way. Wonder if I can detect which way up it goes. Okay, yeah, that is. I mean, they're tiny. They're, you know, that's smaller than I thought. That 1 cc head. It is really small, isn't it? My goodness me, that poor spark plug. No wonder it's not running anymore. Right, that needs a really good wash. That's pretty much the main bit that needs a wash. I suppose I should do the top of that piston, but I don't want that gunk getting down into the engine. So that is the spark plug area. Pretty weird, don't you think? I wonder if opening that up would help a bit. I get the feeling it might. And there we have one of the valves. That is the petrol the mix intake valve. And that looks pretty clean on the underside there. Okay, that's not good enough, is it? There's the exhaust area. So, see if I can improve that a bit somehow. We'll try the brush again. I don't think it's actually getting in there. Maybe it'll just wash through. Yeah, I mean, I think we need to look, I need to look for a brush that will fit in there. So, excuse me a minute. I've just made a comment on one of my videos that I fear that these engines are a little too small, really. You know, 3 cc's or something is better. I really find that a hole a bit weird there, and that hole for the spark plug. And I really wonder if, actually we should be cleaning the spark plug and the exhaust pipe. I really wonder if that would be better drilled out. I mean, it works, you know, but that's weird, isn't it? Having a tiny little hole like that. The spark plug, spark, intake, and right, how are we going in there? That is better. That is better. What we might do is squirt it with our friendly neighborhood syringe. Where are you, syringe? Actually, this will do. This will do nicely. Yes, it will. So suck up some petrol with this. Yeah. Oh, look, I'm splashing petrol everywhere, which is hideous. Let me try and, goodness me, the smell in here you wouldn't believe. And this is Mrs. Wife's kitchen, so yeah, probably not ideal to, you know, probably should have been doing this in the garage. But look, it could be less ideal. I could be doing this with a cigarette hanging out the end of my mouth. We'd all be going up in smoke, wouldn't we? Right, that's a clean cylinder liner. And we have our clean cylinder head. We still need to do this little spark plug that keeps getting poorly thing. I mean, it really was no trouble to take that engine apart, I guess. What'd it take, a minute? Oh God, look at that mess. Right, so we're gonna get some clean petrol soaked cloth. We're finally going to be able to figure out where the top dead center is, where we think it is too. Okay, let's have a look down there. Okay, I've recently cleaned the whole head of this. So we're just going to add a drop of very, very light oil to the inlet valve stem. So I get just a tiny drop out of there. Okay, because we don't, you know, that's got to pop down so lightly. We don't want to use a thick oil in there. Other tweaks we've done recently include building up the part in there that holds the valve up. So that part's been built up with, let's see if I can zoom in. It's been built up with a little bit of good fine steel, of good quality steel. And you'll find that it stops the valve wiggling all over the place when it doesn't need to. So we're going to fill it up with petrol, clean the spark plug first, because it always likes to be cleaned before we run the engine. I couldn't believe that the spark plug was hiding down a wee hole. And it's very tempting to drill out that hole a bit, but, you know, one would hope that the makers of this engine knew what they were doing. And so, not going to do that. The engine's running really well at the moment, so better not tempt fate by doing something I can't reverse, you know? This is no longer bouncing up and down crazily. You can clearly see the little bit of metal I've put on that to hold that up slightly more. Now I could run it slower, as you see. If I run it a lot slower, it may not successfully suck all the petrol through there. So I'm not sure whether I want to run it that slowly. I mean, that's amazing for such a small engine and for such a small flywheel. I'm tempted to build something that will do that for me, do that. And look, I actually found in my garage, I think the smallest G-clamp in the universe. Look at that. It's actually quite strongly built. And I don't know how old it is. It seems to have nickel plating on it. It's just starting to fail around the edges, but if I could use that to do what I've just been doing here with the tweezers in the middle of this, in the middle of the spring, move it up, is that without the spring at all? That's without the spring at all, I believe, not even holding it. And if I hold the spring down tighter, yeah, the muck runs a little bit faster. So, yeah, interesting. That's slow enough for me, and the engine runs really nicely. But look, it is lovely, isn't it? I really am in two minds about that. Beautiful, beautiful engine running really nicely.